In southwestern Colorado sits one of the best preserved and largest complex of prehistoric cliff dwellings in the United States. In the summer of 2018, I had the privilege to visit Mesa Verde National Park. This park is over 52,000 acres and contains over 5,000 archaeological sites, including 600 cliff dwellings. Nestled under the sandstone rock shelters are the superbly constructed pueblos made of mud and sandstone slabs. Share my adventure of discovery as we tour Mesa Verde. The first pueblo I saw was called Spruce Treehouse. It's located right behind the Chapin Archaeological Museum. The engineering and skilled construction reveal that these people were incredibly intelligent and organized enough to be able to build structures that still stand almost 1,000 years later. This pueblo was closed to tours because of unstable rock above the pueblo, so I could only film from the observation point. One of the largest and best known cliff dwellings is called Cliff Palace, which is shown here. These remarkably preserved structures are 800 years old and once supported a thriving community of ancestral Puebloans who survived on a combination of farming and hunting and gathering. The skillful masonry is still evident. I scheduled a guided tour of another pueblo called Balcony House.
Because that's our nearest neighbor that we can see across the canyon there, in that little alcove. You can kind of see their granaries. The sun line, the shadow line goes right across the shelf where their granaries are. We actually can't see the structure itself because it faces a different direction from this perspective. But as you look out across the canyon, well, you look at all the dead trees out there.
Yeah.
You know, you cannot go anywhere in this park as you're driving up, bless you, without noticing all the fires we've had here. And since we've been a national park, Mesa Verde has lost about 79% of its forest. All of those fires were started by lightning, every one of them. The majority of our conflagrations that we've had here, the really big bad ones, have been since about 1996. We make prayer sticks. Carve the stick, decorate it, say a powerful prayer, and then stick it up in the crack.
Rainfall seeps through the porous sandstone until it reaches a layer of impervious shale. Then it filters out, creating these small pools that were a vital water source for the people who lived here.
Has anyone got over to Longhouse on Wetherill Mesa? Longhouse, which is our second largest cliff dwelling in the park. While the people were living there, they lost about a fourth of their pueblo to rockfall. A big chunk of that arch fell off and crushed about a fourth of the pueblo while they were living there.
To reach the ruins, we had to climb up a 30-foot wooden ladder, then slip through a narrow corridor between the rear wall of the structure and the rock. Then we emerged in the first courtyard. Here you can see the balcony that gave Balcony House its name. This is the original structure, and here you can see the mud, wood, and juniper bark that was used to construct the balcony.
Well, I did didn't ever think of it until he said it. They left that doorway open, and when they were done with construction,
we then climbed another shorter ladder and went through another narrow corridor to access the second courtyard. It was a struggle to get through such a narrow passageway. This set of four manos and metates was once used to grind corn, nuts, and acorns. And one last passageway got us out of the pueblo, where we scaled yet another ladder to emerge on top. I then visited the museum and got to see some of the fantastic artifacts that were found here at Mesa Verde.